توكلوا عليه. ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، شر الأمور محدثاتها، كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وما قل وكفى خير مما كثر وألهى، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. إخوة الإيمان والإسلام، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل. All praises due to Allah. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters, the emphasis on seeking the knowledge for the Muslim and the importance of those who possess this knowledge is highly emphasized in Quran and Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The importance of seeking knowledge for a Muslim and the status and the position of those who have that knowledge that gets them closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is highly emphasized in the book of Allah and the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the comparison between those who have the knowledge and those who don't. قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ إِنَّمَا يَتَذَكَّرُ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. Only if you ponder and Allah give you the tool and the heart and the brain to think, you will find out that they are not equal. May Allah make us among those who have that knowledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also associated that knowledge with fearing Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the foundation of this deen. The foundation of this knowledge that will get you closer to Allah is it has to come out of the fear of Allah, the fear that gets you closer to Him. You want to learn more how you get close to Allah as much as you can, and how to get as far as you can from the displeasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّمَا يَخْشَ اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. Truly those who fear Allah are the ones who have the knowledge. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahmatullahi alayhi rahimahullahi says, أَصْلُ الْعِلْمِ خَشْيَةُ اللَّهِ. The root of the knowledge, or رأس العلم, or the head of the knowledge, either the root or the head, important part, root, or the important part is the head. He said, this is the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can possess as much information as you want. Without the fear of Allah, it will never be used properly. It will not be used properly, and it will not lead to the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the intention was not that. So you have to do the right thing for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why, my brothers and sisters, today, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, a few minutes, we will learn about some of the etiquettes of the masjid. Few of them, not all of them. So we understand the importance of seeking the knowledge based on the book of Allah and the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not based on culture, and not thinking only or being able or being happy or being content that what I know is enough for me, I don't need to know anything else. Actually, that attitude itself, or that approach itself, prevents you and me from learning essential knowledge, let alone extra knowledge that gets you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if the attitude is, I know enough, I don't need to know more, what I know is good, don't confuse me more, I don't want more information, that approach in itself prevents you and me from learning essential things, as you will see inshallah, let alone extra bonuses. You prevent yourself. A Muslim is always advised to go and take initiative. You take initiative. سارعوا سابقوا compete take initiative يسارعون إلى الخيرات وهم لها سابقون. They don't wait for people to invite you. You don't wait for knowledge to come to you. You don't wait to be spoon-fed the knowledge. You make the effort to do it. That barakah. There is a barakah in making an effort to learn. Subhanallah, Allah Azza wa Jalla will give you 10 times more than you want. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهِ. When you have that fear of Allah Azza wa Jalla, have the taqwa, Allah will teach you subhanahu wa ta'ala himself. Through me, through any scholar, through any person, through the least of people you may imagine, Allah Azza wa Jalla will give you the means to learn subhanallah. To come closer to him. Masajid, my brothers and sisters, masajid. Masajid, Allah Azza wa Jal made them his houses on earth, subhanallah. And Allah Azza wa Jal claimed ownership himself. وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ. Allah finished the deal from the very beginning. You may build the masjid for whatever reason you want. The ownership goes to Allah Azza wa Jal. And you have to agree on that. No doubt. You should not have any doubt about it. You can build the masjid, you can donate whatever you want, you can teach whatever you want, you can be the authority with whatever you want, however you want, how long you want. In the beginning, at the end, this masjid belongs to who? To Allah. وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. And Allah Azza wa Jal give the name from the biggest and the most important position, which is sujood. You're making sajda to Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Make sajda to Allah, this is the highest and the closest you get to Allah. When you are the lowest physically for Allah, you are the highest of servants closer to Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. You put your head, the highest part in your body, you put it in the lowest part under your feet, for who? For Allah Azza wa Jal. So Allah gives the masjid the name from that. Masjid, from sujood, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, Allah Azza wa Jal told us that nobody can establish a masjid which is accepted by Allah without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فِي بُيُوتٍ أَذِنَ اللَّهُ أَن تُرْفَعَ وَيُذْكَرَ فِيهَا اسْمُهُ. So Allah is the one who gives permission for this house of His to be raised. Without His permission, it would not be raised. So we all have to know that from the depth of our heart. Masjid is from sujood. Masjid is the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Without the tawfiq of Allah, without the help and the support and the acceptance of Allah, these walls will not be raised. Without Allah's support, this jama'ah would not be here. Without Allah's support, subhanahu wa ta'ala, this jum'ah would not have existed here. Appreciate all of that. Before we learn any etiquette, you have to work on your heart and my heart first. We have to work on them. What is this place? The house of Allah. Why I came here? Why it is built? For the sake of Allah. Then comes the question, what do I need to do? What Allah told me to do. How should I do it? I follow the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is the logic. What is this place? House of Allah. Who gave permission for it to be built? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who has ownership on it in the beginning and the end? Rabbul Alameen himself. All from the Quran as we listen. Now what should I do? You should behave according to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How do I know that? Listen to Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look at his companions and then we will know how we deal with our masjid. Then once we have that approach, all cultures go aside. All political games go aside. All approaches go aside. All personal things are aside. And we put all of those reasons of conflict with our shoes on the rack outside. Actually, it should be out even from the premises. Before we come as servant of Allah. This is called masjid from sujood. So you humble yourself down. Don't let the shaitan ride that. Don't let the shaitan spoil your intention. And you come and say, today I'm going to do this. Today I'm going to prove that person wrong. Today I'm going to have that attitude. Subhanallah. Subhanallah, how much of good deeds you want to waste? It's very little that we have. And we are risking it every single day just for little feelings or little, you know, satisfaction or feeling of, you know, not real gratification. Subhanallah. Masajid, My brothers and sisters, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always emphasized on how you deal with it. How you deal with it. When a person comes to the masjid and he try to do something that he's not supposed to do, Rasulullah said, masjid is not built for that. So the emphasis here is, you have to know and I have to know what this masjid is built for. For the dhikr of Allah, for the salah, for the recitation of Quran, for tahajjud, for ibadah, and whatever the community agrees on that this masjid to be done to get closer to Allah and to maintain us as Muslim individual and community. Without any innovation, without any contradiction to Quran and Sunnah. So masjid is in the West. Masjid in the West is the identity of the Muslim. Is where we console each other when we have problems. Is where we sit together when we're happy. Is where we sit together and have meals. Is where, you know, people get educated, young and old and brothers and sisters. Because you are in this ocean of disbelief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Masjid is where you identify with. So it has to serve that purpose. It is more than just the musalla. Facilities and activities and other things, and all this should be respected. Because it leads to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So ta'zim and the honor of the sha'air of Allah, the honor of the rights of Allah, sha'air, is the place where you worship Allah, is the action with which you worship Allah, is how you do that action, all of these called sha'air of Allah. ذَلِكَ وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ حُرُمَاتِ اللَّهِ ذَلِكَ مَنْ عَظِمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. It is a proof of the taqwa in your heart is to respect the masjid. That's why I always say, you show your taqwa when you follow the discipline of the masjid. You show your taqwa when you are told there is a shoe rack, you put your shoes on it, you respect the house of Allah by doing that. When you say keep the masjid clean, you respect the masjid of Allah when you keep it clean. Don't raise your voices in the masjid, so you know I'm not going to raise my voice in the masjid and distract others, because this is a respect, you know, for the house of Allah. When there is a rule, you follow it. As long as this rule is not in the disobedience of Allah and is not against the sunnah of Rasulullah SAW, is to be disciplined as a jama'ah and the community. So it is not about your individual feeling anymore. It is about the jama'ah, subhanallah. Like we respect, these are hours to do such and such. This place is for brothers, and at that time for sisters. Then all our personal things should stay aside. That's how we achieve, subhanallah, the jama'ah. As a jama'ah, we achieve the goal. Sometimes it's against your own personal benefit. That's fine. Because you will benefit by the community benefiting, inshaAllah, Rabbul Alameen. So the masajid, Allah Azza wa Jal told us, when we're coming to the masjid, we have to look our best, smell our best, carry ourselves the best way possible. يَا بَنِي آدَمْ خُذُوا زِينَتَكُمْ عِنْدَ كُلِّ مَسْجِدٍ خُذُوا زِينَتَكُمْ عِنْدَ كُلِّ مَسْجِدٍ. Take your adornment the best way it should be when you are going to the masjid, to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah, we want to look good in front of each other, humans, servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not for anything except we want each other to feel good. When we are invited to a wedding or a walima or a aqiqah or a gathering, or you are going for an interview or apply for a job, or just going to a place to socialize, you wanted to fit, you wanted to look good for that place. You ask what is the dress code and you go follow it. Subhanallah, is it casual? Is it business casual? Is it this? Is it that? And in the work, this is a casual day. Everybody make sure that they want to follow what agreed upon. And when we come to the masjid, it becomes the least to care about, subhanallah. Why, my brothers and sisters? Why we don't make that effort to look good, subhanallah, in front of Allah who give you this ni'mah to have nice clothes? You come to the masjid with the best of clothes and smell. Subhanallah, my brothers and sisters, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, whoever ate garlic or onion or chives or something like that and the smell come out from their masjid, don't come to the masjid. Coming to the masjid is important. Doing salah is fard. Jama'ah is, he is encouraging. He is even threatened to punish those who intentionally not to come for jama'ah. And somebody ate the food which is halal. but it would result in offending the community, he said, don't come. Allahu Akbar. Don't come. So that's not about yourself or how you feel comfortable. Like everybody, oh, I am such and such, I feel this, and I'm going to make a big issue if people do not follow what I'm saying. No. If you ate the food which is allowed by Allah Azza wa Jal, which is allowed by Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, but is going to make an offensive smell, don't come to the masjid. The Sahaba themselves used to make sure they follow that literally. If somebody comes and they smell, they will escort him out of the masjid. And they will go. I forgot, I'm sorry, I will not do it again. Sahaba of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Now smelling of that which is halal. Imagine if somebody come with a smoke smell. Or somebody come with a sweat. Because even if they work, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam specifically said, when somebody coming to Salatul Jum'ah, make sure you are wearing thawbain, two pieces of clothes or a piece of clothes other than your work uniform. So if you are coming from work and the clothes of your work smells, have an extra piece of clothes in your car. When you come and do wudu, make sure you have deodorant or something. Wallahi, I was so happy yesterday when I walked into the bathroom of this masjid and I found some of the kids, subhanallah, after they played a game and it was the time for salah. And then I find deodorant and perfumes and things in the wudu area. Yes, these things should be commended. We are very good in criticizing, but we are not good in commending. Our youth and our people should commend it and make it a point, even to say it in the khutbah of Jum'ah. We commend those and continue in that. Those are the ideas we need in our masajid, subhanallah. So if somebody running out of time, they come before the salah, before the adhan, they do the wudu, and then they spray themselves to smell good, and they come, mashallah, to the masjid. That is something to be proud of. And that is how to follow on the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah bless those who came up with this idea, and may Allah bless those who executed that and who put those good smells in the bathroom and the wudu area. It's very important. Islam is the deen of tahara, purification, and the deen of cleanliness, my brothers and sisters. When you enter the masjid, there is adab also when you enter the masjid with your right foot and you say the dua by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There are books of dua everywhere. I advise everybody, get that book or get a soft copy or download it in your app store or play store, whatever store it is on the phone. Download that. But read the dua of entering the masjid, the dua of exiting the masjid, the dua before the wudu, the dua after wudu. We need to have that dhikr in our life, my brothers and sisters. So khutbah of Jum'ah is not enough. Today we are just thinking about some of those two, just trigger some positive way of thinking. That is the whole approach of today, not to tell you 1, 2, 3. You are, inshallah, the one who is going to find all of this information. It's already there. I'm not bringing anything new, subhanallah. The dua when you enter the masjid, dua when you exit the masjid. When you enter the masjid, you come early for the salah. It is emphasized in the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, especially Salatul Jum'ah. If you come early before Salatul Jum'ah, 2 or 3 hours before Salatul Jum'ah, Allah give you. You give a camel, then as if you give a cow, then as if you give a sheep, then as if you give a chicken, then as if you give an egg, in sadaqah, in charity before you come. Imagine, before you come to Salatul Jum'ah, you give $10,000 sadaqah. Or you give $2,000 sadaqah. Or you give $1,000 sadaqah, $500 sadaqah, or $5 sadaqah. Before you come to the masjid, subhanallah, you feel good? You feel so good? Before you sit in front of Allah and learn, I already donated for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't have to do that literally, which we all have issues with reaching to our wallet. So Allah Azza wa Jalla said, I will give you as if you did that without doing it. Just come early to the masjid. Subhanallah. So my brothers and sisters, you come. Salatul Jum'ah. Many people, for example, tell me, and that's why telling you sometimes the sunnah is strange for us. Some people said, ya Shaykh, you always in the Jum'ah, look on the right side. Or the imams look on the left side. Well, the sunnah of Rasulullah not to look either. Sunnah of Rasulullah that you look at the imam from both sides, and the imam only look in front of him. So that's the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sunnah of Rasulullah is to come closer to the imam. To come closer, as close as you can to the khutbah. To listen and to pay attention. The sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not to interlace your fingers and sit like this in the while you are waiting for the salah. sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam is not to talk during Salatul Jum'ah with each other, even to correct somebody or to tell somebody be quiet. He made a mistake by violating the khutbah, by talking to other than the imam, or and somebody violated as well by talking to them. So that shows us the importance of listening and studying and learning. May Allah make us among those who listen and follow the best of what they listen to. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه وولاه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. It's important, my brothers and sisters, when you enter the masjid to pray the two rak'ah. And those two rak'ah, even though they call tahiyyatul masjid, they are the two rak'ah for Allah. You are not praying to the masjid. I had a brother a couple of weeks ago coming to me and said, I have some issue, ya Sheikh, in my heart from praying the two rak'ah tahiyyatul masjid. I said, why? He said, you know, how we should pray to Allah. Why should I pray to the walls and to the ceiling? You think tahiyyatul masjid means you praying to the masjid. I said, ya akhi, subhanallah. وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. All this deen is for Allah. When you say Allahu Akbar, the niyyah is to Allah Azza wa Jal. تحيات المسجد here, it does not mean all the salah you pray to Allah and this salah you pray to this masjid. No. تحيات المسجد means it's the first thing you do when you enter the place. This is what it means. But it's at the end, beginning at the end, it's for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you enter in Salatul Jum'ah, you make sure you pray to rak'ah before you sit, even if the khatib is giving khutbah. And this is a dua, this is a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah did it with Sulayk al-Ghatafan. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu did it with Uthman ibn Affan. And all the khalifas, they did it with somebody who entered the masjid, sit down, said, stand up and pray to rak'ah. So you pray to rak'ah even if it is the second khutbah. Pray to rak'ah and make it simple and easy. Adab of the masjid also, when there is a halqa of ilm, you should respect it as well. If the imam, there is difference among the scholars, with the imam, is known, or the jama'ah is known, that there is a regular salah, don't distract, even by reading Quran. If you don't want to attend the halqa of ilm, stay away. But don't distract each other. We don't distract someone praying by reading Quran, or someone reading Quran by praying loud. Everybody has to respect everybody, because we all want the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The masjid should be away from our business transactions, from eating and drinking. Especially during programs, educational programs, or during the salah, should avoid these activities, because this is not the time for that. This is the time now you come for the dhikr. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu idha nudiya ila as-salati min yawm al-jum'ati fas'au ila dhikrillah. Fas'au ila dhikrillah. Go to the dhikr of Allah. That's what you're going for. That's why Allah Azza wa Jalla said, when the dhikr of Allah finish, go to the affairs of your dunya. Business transaction and eating and drinking and having relationships and socializing and everything after. Not during, not while it is happening, my brothers and sisters. Also, my sisters, everything for the men applies to you. Once you come to the masjid, regardless what is the ruling of you coming to the masjid, you are at the masjid now. Your lines has to be straight like the brother's line has to be straight. No gaps between each other while you are in the salah, like the brothers don't have over that. You don't talk and socialize because you're just women and the khutbah or the jum'ah is not fardu on you. That means you talk while the imam or the khatib is talking. No, stop talking. And don't make excuses that we are not in the masjid, we are away, we cannot see. No, stop talking and enforce that rule among yourselves. Don't pray separately. Pray in the same group following the imam. This is discipline, my brothers. Please take your ego and your vanity and all of these issues out. As I mentioned in the beginning, salah is salah, masjid is masjid. Why are you here and where are you? You are at the house of Allah and you are here to please Allah Azza wa Jal. So put what you feel aside. Even if there are hukm in something, you believe in it, but then the imam or the group believes in something, follow the jama'ah, follow the imam. That is how it is, my brothers and sisters. We can go on and on and on the adab of the masjid. We had a lecture a couple of weeks ago. It's recorded on our site, alhamdulillah, about more etiquettes of the masjid. So I'd advise everybody to go, but I got requested from many brothers and sisters to make it in a khutbah. Adab in masjid. When you dress, make sure you are following the dress code. Dress code is for brothers as well as for sisters. When you dress, make sure that your clothes is known, urf, among the people, that it is respectable clothes. You come with clothes that does not distract people. I don't want to see people, subhanAllah, coming with short or having things on their shirts and something distract everybody. And you sit behind someone who have a big, mashallah, news bulletin on the back of their shirt. And you keep reading that news bulletin instead of listening to the imam. Or someone, they are not dressed properly. Their pants are down and you can see their back and you can see below their back as well. So this is very important, my brothers and sisters. Don't do these things. Somebody will make sujood, all your back shows. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. You're an adult, subhanAllah. Pay attention to these things for brothers as well as for sisters. خلاصه, summary of today's khutbah, because we're running over time now, my brothers and sisters. This is the house of Allah. Allah give it a name from the position that you get you closest to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask ourselves, what is this place? It is the house of Allah. Allah claimed authority and ownership over it. You have to follow and do what pleases Allah according to the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When we agree on a system as a jama'ah, we have to follow it. We have to follow that system because achieving as a jama'ah precedes what you achieve as an individual. Even what you achieve as an individual is more emphasized. It's better. Have more dalil on it. But we have, as a jama'ah, agreed on something, follow that bi'ithnillahi ta'ala. Respect the halqa of knowledge. Respect the masjid. Come early, come clean, come very good. Don't raise your voices. No argument in the masajid. No distracting each other. Always be concerned about the masjid. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless our jama'ah and our community. Please, my brothers and sisters, go learn the etiquettes of the masjid. Learn the etiquettes of the masajid and try to apply one etiquette once a month, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Every month, pick one etiquette. There are 10, 15 of them until bi'ithnillahi ta'ala. Within a year, we are all as a jama'ah, 1,000 people come to the masjid with the same etiquette. You find uniformity, you find harmony. Our hearts will follow bi'ithnillah. Allahumma ghafir lana dhunubana wa kaffir anna sayyiatina wa tawaffana ma'al abrar. Rabbana ghafir lana warhamna wa anta khairul rahimin. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك واغننا بفضلك عن من سواك. اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته، ولا هما إلا فرجته، ولا غما ولا كربا إلا كشفته، ولا مريضا إلا شفيته، ولا ميتا إلا رحمته، ولا محتاجا إلا أعطيته، ولا حاجة لك فيها رضا ولنا فيها صلاح إلا قضيتها ويسرتها رب العالمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين. اللهم كن لعبادك المستضعفين في كل أرض ومكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم رد ديار الإسلام إلى حظيرة الإسلام يا رب العالمين. اللهم كن لإخواننا المستضعفين، كن لإخواننا الجائعين، كن لإخواننا الأسرى والمسجونين يا رب العالمين. اللهم فك أسرانا وارحم موتانا مرضانا واقض حوائجنا واغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم اشرح صدورنا ونور قلوبنا وخذ بنواصينا إلى صراطك المستقيم. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأقم الصلاة.